We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Rita of Cassia, a religious and patroness for impossible cases. Let us ask her prayers and intercession, especially among us who are facing challenges that sometimes look insurmountable. Remember, there is nothing impossible with God. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us also acknowledge that we are all sinners in need of God's mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the wisdom and strength of the cross, with which you were pleased to endow Saint Rita, so that suffering in every tribulation with Christ, we may participate ever more deeply in his paschal mystery, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint James. Beloved, come now, you who say, today or tomorrow we shall go into such and such a town, spend a year there doing business, and make a profit. You have no idea what your life will be like tomorrow. You are a puff of smoke that appears briefly and then disappears. Instead, you should say, if the Lord wills it, we shall live to do this or that. But now you are boasting in your arrogance. All such boasting is evil. So for one who knows the right thing to do and does not do it, it is a sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Hear this, all you peoples. Hearken, all who dwell in the world of lowly birth or high degree, rich and poor alike.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Why should I fear in evil days, when my wicked snares ring me round? They trust in their wealth, the abundance of their riches is their boast.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Yet in no way can a man redeem himself, or pay his own ransom to God. Too high is the price to redeem one's life. He would never have enough to remain alive always and not see destruction.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
For he can see that wise men die, and likewise the senseless and the stupid pass away. leaving to others their wealth.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Please stand.
I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. And welcome to those who are not regular churchgoers. Marami kayo ngayon eh, no? Hindi naman itong ordinary weekday mass attendance. But I understand some of you are from Paco Catholic School. So welcome. My dear sisters and brothers, our first reading is from the letter of St. James. And it will be the source of the first reading until Saturday. And in this reading for today, we are being reminded of two things. Number one, life is short. And you do not know what is going to happen tomorrow. James had a beautiful way of comparing. He said, "You are a puff of smoke that appears briefly and then disappears." A puff of smoke. Usok lang daw tayo nan makikita and then pagkatapos maglalaho. That is why he is reminding his reader, St. James, you have no idea of what your life will be like tomorrow. Alam ba ninyo kung anong mangyayari bukas? O mamayang hapon? We cannot really say. Because tomorrow, for some, may never come. And so, the advice of St. James in this first statement is, do the best, the right thing that you can do now. Don't wait until tomorrow. For tomorrow, in one's case, may never come anymore. Kaya, kung makakapagpatawad ka ngayon, huwag mo nang sabihin, bukas na lang. Kung makagagawa ka ng mabuti ngayon, huwag mo nang sabihin, bukas na lang. Kung sasagutin mo rin lamang yun ng liligaw sa'yo ngayon, sabihin mo nang, oo, ngayon. Huwag nang bukas pa. Baka iwan ka na niyan. No? Di ba? Kasi kumisan kayo mga babae, kung magpahirap kayo ng mga nanliligaw eh, no? Pero doon din naman ang uwi, no? What you can do now, today, don't wait until tomorrow. Because as St. James would say, you are a puff of smoke that appears briefly and then disappears. The second reminder to us is this. Since we are not God, we have no control of everything. And so St. James is telling us, when you pray like this, Lord, if it is your will, let it be done to me. Because if the Lord wills it, we shall live to do this or that. So ang sabi ni St. James, no, hindi naman tayo Diyos eh. Wala tayong control. And some people would like to have control over everything. Kaya siya nai-stress. I can understand the academic personnel now, no? Okay? Is everything all right? All the certificates are here. All the medals are available. What time are we going to assemble? And so on and so forth. Ilang araw na kayong stress. And sometimes we are like that. Because we want to control everything. Maybe we have to learn to say, well, I have done my part. I leave everything to the Lord. Hindi po tayo Diyos. Iisa lang ang Diyos at hindi tayo yon. Gawin natin ang pwede natin gawin at ang lahat ipaubaya natin sa Panginoon. You know, the saint that we are celebrating today, Saint Rita of Cassia, is, as I have said earlier, is the patroness of the impossible cases. Meron po tayong simbahan sa may Parañaque na naka-dedicate sa kanya, Santa Rita de Cassia. Si Santa Rita ay pinagdaanan yung mga mahihirap na pagsubok. Naranasan niya yung mga mabibigat na problema. Pero hindi siya nawala ng pagtitiwala sa Diyos. For her, God knows everything, and there is nothing impossible with God. That is what St. James is saying in his letter. If that is God's will, it will happen. And so, when we pray, Lord, whatever you wish, whatever you will, let your will be done. Amen.
Please all stand.
In the past several weeks, we have been praying for rain, and somehow the Lord is answering our prayer. But we continue to pray to the Lord to give us gentle rain. Together, God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people, whom she loves. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Santa Rita de Casia,
pray for us. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We bring the offerings of our devotion to be consecrated by you, O Lord, in commemoration of Blessed Rita of Casia. For by the consolation you give us in this life, you show us that we should not lose hope of what is promised for eternity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Saint Rita, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us love like Jesus, let us pray like Jesus. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Renewed, O Lord, at the wellspring of salvation, we humbly entreat you that through the intercession of Blessed Rita, holding more closely day by day to Christ, we may merit to be co-heirs in his kingdom of grace, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I again would like to invite you to join us in our Wednesday Family Rosary tonight at 9 p.m. The hosts of our weekly rosary will be the community of San Isidro Labrador Parish in Malhacan, Meycauayan, Bulacan. So that will be at 9 in the evening via the Facebook page of the Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.